welcome to the stream. Probably nobody here yet. That's fine.
Did I get a notification? I get a notification when we go live.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, fancy. Oh, you fancy.
Not on yet.
It takes it
a second to load, yeah.
I've noticed it's a little slower on the Mac version.
Bust your deck out, fool. And then beat a 10.
Beat a 10? I didn't beat a 10. I got half to 10. This mouse out of here. Yep, we're live. Off we go. Even ourself.
I haven't even gotten a notification. Let's see.
Still working. Dreaming. It looks good. Corey takes a mulligan. I'm going to see if I can So. Pretty sure I have to mulligan this. Ooh, do I though? Actually, I might not have to.
Because it's game one.
Yeah.
Because
it's game one.
Chris is really scared post game for no real reason. It's just a head game that you have.
It's the legacy of the boy, man. It's terrifying. It's hard to beat, you know? Alright, so I think what we're going to do is pretty much this, pitching this, which will dump this, which will, let's do this. It's explosive. I don't know if it's game ending though. Let's try it. Yeah.
Alright,
keep
on a sky. Shots for zero.
Ooh. Oh, we lose. Okay.
Go ahead.
That's not good. We'll go to discard.
Hold on. Four discard.
Okay.
Four discard.
Ends up?
Yeah. Cycle break one. Drop.
Sure.
Yeah.
So all hope is not lost. We can hopefully draw no land. We're gonna mate this and be good with life. See, he knew to do that child on zero because he listened to us.
Such.
Punk.
Scoundrels.
Scoos is good.
Okay.
Alright, we need to land right now. That's not the land right now. Oh. We're going to unmask. Get rid of Futsies.
Sure. Yeah,
I'll take your hands on you. That's fine. That's
sure. Shots for one.
Top deck's the chest.
Yeah.
Brutal.
It's pretty brutal.
Can we just go to game two, boys? We probably play that because we're on camera. It seems fair. Let's see how it goes.
Right.
There it goes.
I'll eat your chest full time. Again, life.
Things just got real bad.
I'm at 20 because of the
camera. So we need unmask.
Swing for three.
Sure.
I'll pass back to you.
Oh, we get the unmask. Go to my end step.
Could you clean up?
My end step. It's pretty much kind of have to. Ugh, so bad.
So, are you going to clean up?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. I'm going to copy Thespian Stage onto the bayou.
Sure.
Very good.
You mean the bayou onto the Thespian Stage?
Thespian Stage is going to copy the bayou.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
All right. Me?
Well, yeah. I'll swing for three. Another real card.
Sure.
Go ahead.
Night.
I messed up. I should have beaten the Faithless Loot.
Yeah. It's inconsequential at this point with all my
it's true. It's just it would have been clean play, right? Unless you had
nice, crisp, clean play, it seems like.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess there's argument for surgical extraction, but you wouldn't have it game one and have Chalice of Void, so.
Yeah. Or would I have a game one?
This is 7.
So, yes, I'll concede. Okay. There's no way to come back at this point. Got those there. Those lovely belches brought to you by Firestone. What are we drinking? Oatmeal stout.
Velvet Merlin is another beer. It's quite delicious.
Alright, so for those of you wondering, these four blanks are Reverent Silence, which is one green and three colorless mana for total CMC. Basically, if I control a forest, it's an alternate casting cost. I can have him gain six life and destroy all enchantments. It's a sorcery. Reverent Silence. Look it up. They're in the mail, they just haven't arrived. Sad times for Chalice on zero, Chalice on one. Pretty good.
Do you know how to... Like, is there any way to program this where you can sync up to that to run an app that would connect with that?
No, I mean, I could update it in real time, like, if I were to go on OBS, but it would, I'd really have to go update the text. It can be kind of inefficient to do it.
Well, I was just thinking, it would be kind of cool if you could create on here different squares with, like, my name, the deck name, and then the color behind it, and then we could just change that to...
And have it show up here?
Yeah.
I don't know how to do that, I mean,
right.
Above my capabilities, but, I mean, it sounds cool. This is right, but that's why we grabbed it, right?
Right.
Alright, game two, match one.
And you're on the play.
I'm on the play. It seems like that's the smart thing to do. I'm not a doctor, but...
As is tradition.
As is tradition. The funny thing about that Facebook post was, no, those were false when I was a kid. Let's see. I think I...
Oh, four.
Yeah. It's pretty rough.
Is that any card?
Any black card.
No. For me, is it?
It's choose a non-land card.
So I'm a non-land card. Still really good.
This is the right choice.
Good.
Sure.
Counter to the Chancellor.
Sure.
Good.
That's top deck entry. Is Phyrexian Altar legal in EDH or Primeval type? And what is that? You use the line I have stuck so well.
Okay, no way. Is Phyrexian Altar legal in EDH? Or Primeval Titan? I think Phyrexian Altar is, and Prime Titan is not. Prime Titan, it's just too good. And like a free-for-all four-man game. Same thing with like Sylvan Primordial. That card was so legit.
Yeah.
Come in.
Bam.
Destroy land. So Phyrexian Altar, is that the one that you sacrifice a creature and get two colorless mana, right?
That's not Phyrexian Tower?
No. Phyrexian Tower is the land that does gives two black mana, right?
Right.
Phyrexian Altar, isn't that the one that you can like go infinite with?
I don't know.
6 second shit.
I don't know. I know Primetime is banned because they just sold me one and I tried to play it and everybody laughed at me.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was good. I spent that money. yeah, I'm done.
I just casted the Scamble News.
Oh, yeah.
Press back, too.
It's a weak excuse you got there, bro. I ain't doing much.
Yep. Neither are we, folks.
I'm going to eat Dark Confidant. I'm getting life.
All right. How does he exist? Oh, no, that's just me.
That's just you.
Ah, that card's so good.
Sink three.
All right.
That fetch. Casting over.
Force of will. Three, six, seven. We are at capacity. Yes.
See, this is where I think Brainstorm's just like so much better. Help you dig for a hate card, right? I guess it gets just my deck. My deck's kind of fringe, right? Or not fringe, but not like the most common.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I can't make that decision. Two's better than one. Fetch land, dude. That's what we want, right? Round turn?
Yeah.
Ooh, that's not a fetch land. It's a land, but it's not a fetch land.
Oh, yeah, you want green. You want green.
Need that green.
Need the green.
I didn't think of that. We pass, and we're going to take something to the face.
6.
Alright, we gotta get there next turn. It's gotta happen. I don't think it's gonna, though.
I'll copy your song.
Thief.
Four, seven.
No, you just put it on. Okay. Alright, this is it, folks. Top deck. Is not gonna do. Alright, well, all the hate, it's real.
Do a D board?
I mean, you wanna do it in matches, or do you wanna just keep playing game twos?
Whatever you want to do. Play another game two.
Yeah, that one kind of is pretty eventful, I'd imagine.
And that, sirs, is how you beat Dark Red Reanimator without
blue magic.
Yeah, without force move. A Chalice for zero, man. I would like that. I thought that was like a trick play. I was like, this is either gonna like bite me in the ass, or this is gonna be like the shit.
No, well, it crippled me because I was gonna go off on a pedal, but I assumed you got that information because I was talking about it to the camera. So.
No. I had no way of playing it.
Yeah.
Turn one, okay. Right?
Yeah.
So to me, that was like, okay, I can't like stop him from going off this turn.
Right.
If I play for zero, I can stop you from playing Petal and Mox Diamond, so hopefully I can stop you from, like, reanimating this turn,
sure.
And then draw the Mox Diamond next
yeah.
turn and try to play Scavenging Ooze and, like, eat.
If you hadn't done that, I would have had Patch Bat turn one. Turn
yeah.
zero or whatever, so.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh. Yeah, I'll keep.
Still looking a bit weird. Okay, fine.
Yeah. You want to put it back on the...
Yeah.
And then the void.
Okay.
Sure.
Spell? Times? Reverend Silence, for those who were watching earlier. Destroy all enchantments, fight him 6 life and out of forest.
Yeah.
For red?
Yep.
It's
yep.
This turn. Random.
Fuck, man.
6.
Oh, jeez. Alright. Yeah.
Yeah. Sometimes it works. Good mindset.
Yeah.
Like you.
Go ahead. Take 6?
Yep.
Which one?
Good mindset.
Hopefully I can hit, like, another black land and then a Liliana Veil.
Dude. Oh! One bit closer. Not good.
Six.
Good. Set.
All right,
good.
So...
2 turns, baby. We gotta dodge a Lily. We can do this.
Okay. So do that, or, like, I can hit Maze of Ith with Life and Alone.
You have to hit
but
it.
I have
this
to,
range.
I just, like,
you have to hit this range if you do it. Though.
Yeah. No. I hit 8 life.
Right, but
I mean,
you need
for 6.
You need to. Hit, you, it won't matter if it comes back on the like,
right.
The
right.
Prior, I don't think. Oh, maybe it still will.
Can't do that. Maybe so. Shit. Do I just like maybe hit a scavenging and come back that way? Alright, I just gotta, okay, draw.
Okay.
Oh, wasteland.
What?
Go ahead.
We don't need no thinking lands. Alright, go to my set.
Alright, draw.
Come on, baby.
Oh, Maelstrom Pulse! Oh!
No! Oh my god! Did you pay for that?
I have.
No!
Yeah.
So a game of life at least?
No. Come on.
Sunshock.
Alright. That's your turn, yeah.
Go.
This is, you don't have to discard.
I don't have to discard anymore.
oh
my god.
No, I can't do that. Go ahead. I'm done.
Land, go.
Judge.
Oh my god. It's heartbreak.
There's a Lily and a Thalia. Life and Alone. Targeting Grove, Wasteland, Drinking.
Yeah.
Alright.
good.
You can get them. I will cycle trick to take a draw card. Dredge.
Those of you tuning in, we had Sire for the win until he got to 2 life. That made Reverend Silence actually kill me, technically. I mean, I was able to play him, but...
I'm going to Wasteland him.
Sure.
Cast Life and Alone, targeting Barrymore, Grove the Burn Willows, Trinket the Good.
Sure.
I don't know why he did that. Oh, because he wants to cycle that. I get it. That's cute.
Yeah.
That's Mulcher stepping in.
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
We're going to pass.
You can get away.
I can.
Joker.
Sure.
Joker.
Sure.
Cycle down.
Yep.
Digging for an answer. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, go ahead.
Come on, baby. Flying for the win.
Joker.
Yeah.
We can do this. No, we can't do this, boys.
This is the most uphill battle.
Float of color, or float of green. Sack.
Sure. Sure.
Respond, actually. Yeah.
What?
7 life, okay.
My turn?
No, it's your turn. It's your turn now.
Sure. totally misplayed. I picked the wrong creature entirely, so I'm going to try to do that. Cool.
Okay.
Sure. For those of you watching at home, I should have done this a Gristle Brand ago. But this is why we play, we learn. Oh, yeah. What am I going to do about your draw?
Then did Link look at any drugs?
Then dead. Does he have Trample? Right?
Yep. Trample Shroud, Idlewalk. Idlewalk being pretty good.
Colorless white.
You just played them?
No. I just played one and it's something.
I mean, technically speaking.
Fetch. Go ahead.
Don't look. What are they?
Six sixes.
Okay, but I have seven, so you still die, right?
No.
I just do 6, 7, 1. And divide it how I want, right?
Well, it has to hit them before it hits me.
Oh, it has to hit both of them?
Yeah, that's what trample is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, actually, they're 8-8s.
I don't fucking believe it.
Oh my god.
I should have checked on the knights.
I was I was sitting there doing nothing for a while, and I was so scared because I like loaned the one chalice, and I was like, fuck, man.
To be honest, I lost that game when I didn't get the...
Tides of Tide the first time?
No, not Tides, but the...
Oh, yeah.
I just fucking forgot I had it in the deck. God damn it. Poor shit.
Well, that's why we play.
Yeah. And we lost somebody because we're terrible. But that's cool.
Does this have infect on there? Not that it
yes.
matters.
I think it does. I don't
want to
read your app. Get
wrecked.
I think it does somewhere. I feel like I've seen it. Because that's for complete mobile image. This changes the background. Oh, yeah, there it is. Yeah, I've seen it. Therapy. Oh, you had an infection I gotta worry about?
No. I believe it's a 3-0, sir.
Oh, yeah. Should probably change that. Fringy.
What's fringy? Your deck. My deck? My deck is a deck, though. It's not like it's not everyone. It's mostly European.
I see European.
Man, you know what sucks? Is like there's hands I want to keep, but I can't keep them against you.
Yeah.
I'm only doing this. I should have kept.
Correct. I'm only doing it too, so it's fine.
Get wrecked. Well, I am on the play. So. Well, I mean, I am going to draw. So you can just go off before I can play.
I should probably board differently because of this.
Differently because of what? Because the results are here?
No, because I'm on play.
Oh. What would you board in?
Nothing. This is actually how I board. I just had a beer, so I'm not thinking straight.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Scry.
Yeah. Did I draw 7? I totally drew 7.
Oh, man.
Draw 7.
Draw 7?
Alright. Let's do it to undraw. Undecided. I'm keeping this amazing hand.
Alright, yeah. Cool.
Alright. I'm going to unmask. Because I only have a dead target myself.
Okay.
Alright.
Okay.
Well, we gotta get on the board. This deck is better than pilot. It should be able to clock a win here. I don't know how to play this deck, it doesn't have blue in it. What am I doing? My brainstorms. Cash range. Very unique problem, I think.
Yeah.
Not.
Ooh.
Maelstrom Pulse. That! That was so rough. You missed that. Got into 2 with Sire of Insanity and he Maelstrom Pulsed it off the top deck. Exactly right. Then the lands. Brutal.
Cycle Champion's a good job.
Yep.
Chance Wizard. Yeah. Go ahead.
Seven.
Boom.
Thanks to everyone who's watching. We appreciate the viewership. We like watching Live Legacy just as much as you do. Thought we'd make some.
Thoughts of certainty.
Woo! What would be a super invasion target? Just blow you out. Let's try that. River of Silence.
Take the ropes, okay.
Can't counter it. Seems fair.
Green Sun Space.
Sure, get that Dryad Arbor.
No, that's true.
When you went to block with my knights, I did it again. I'm like, he's flying in the art, not in real life. Great.
Alright, Liliana the Veil is my only out.
You can do it, I believe in you. No? You did it last time.
Right. Can't do it every time.
I mean, it feels like you're a gym, so.
Yeah, it's just that drama, you know?
That moment.
No, no, that was good. Get to be on the play this time.
Whee! I should change my board, but I'm not gonna.
Life short,
and then you reanimate. Any pregame actions?
No. Okay.
Reverend Silence is land. I'd probably bat in. I probably should get that amateur hour over here.
Yeah. I'll take your pedal.
Yes. pass. Go to Mates.
Remove the charge card.
Go with me.
Yep. Gotcha.
Ugh.
Soon for two.
Wow. What is that? Is it
top deck? Yeah, it was top deck, yeah.
Pretty sure you just kicked this.
I'm pretty sure I just did focus. Is that focus?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think so. I think it was fine. Sorry for kicking the camera, everyone. But yes, I did just top deck the Thespian stage.
Pretty good.
That was a pretty good top
deck.
Yeah.
I guess I should draw then.
Yeah.
That's not gonna do it. I do that, boys. Well, you know, keep playing this matchup, you're gonna switch it up. That's 4-1, so that seems like a pretty commanding
yeah.
victory.
Yeah, give me miracles. I don't play miracles.
Alright.
Why'd you make me want to play miracles, Chris?
Corey is famous for not liking blue.
I hate blue.
Hating the control and all that stuff.
Just pass go, or like draw card go. Like, let's stop playing Magic.
Corey likes to make big green creatures.
But the other night, I was playing against Chris, and he had Miracles. I'm like, okay, I'll play Miracles on that. And I just felt the power that is Miracles in my hands. It felt very good. Kind of feel that way when I play lands, you know?
Huge, throbbing, veiny power of Miracles.
But it seemed better than lands, because, I don't know, there's not a lot, like... Lands feels like it, like a combo deck where it just, if it doesn't have the right pieces to get the engine going, it's just not good at all.
Sure.
So, okay, so for this matchup, I have two Swords of Plowshares, just, that's like the worst card to bring in, but I have pretty bad cards that are already in my deck. But just having removal against his dudes, other than like Inkwell Leviathan.
You want me to stay on this? I'm fine with staying on this if you want to.
Sure.
Does it, yeah.
So I bring in the Swords of Plowshares for that, but it's honestly the worst card that I in my sideboard for it, but still good enough. Thalia, as you saw, Thalia was really good when he was only one land, which that deck's kind of known for being on. And most combo decks, just being to play a bunch of spells, obviously taxing them, making him have to have one more, is really good. Layla and the Boy, for any graveyard deck, it's not mine. Well, it just hits every other graveyard but mine, which I need a graveyard for my engine run in my deck with like Knight of the Reliquaries, Life in the Loam, obviously, Punishing Fire, things like that. I want to have my graveyard, so I don't want them out there. Plus, I've played against decks like Dredge and stuff, where even just hardcasting this, having like the Mox Diamonds and like mana, will actually still be a significant thing, right?
Yeah, I mean, you still get there. It's still castable.
Yeah.
Especially for your deck.
So if we're just kind of both dirtling back and forth, and I get this stick before you have any graveyard interactions, it's great.
Great.
Thoughtseize, again. You know, these cards aren't like the best with Chalice for one, but you don't always have Chalice in your hand, and just having like a turn one play to interact is like pretty important. And then Continue Priest, just because it's fucking awesome. Does shut off Green Sun Zenith, but like I only have two Green Sun Zeniths in the deck, so no big deal. So board these in, and then what I took out of the deck was these are the obvious cards.
Here comes the miracles.
Right. And then these three, like, I'm still up in the air with Liliana, because, like, obviously against Inkwell Leviathan, it's really good, but having three mana is, like, really slow against your deck. Tireless Shocker for the same reason. I do keep Ninth, obviously, because that card's just stellar. Can fetch me up Krakus and Maze of Ith and then obviously the Dark Depths combo. But I don't really need to worry about like card advantage. I just need to worry about like interacting in the beginning game stages of the game with Black Ivory Animator. And then Sylvan Library for that same reason. This is just more of a grindy card. And I'm not trying to grind against him. I'm trying to just like control the board state and then swing and win or whatever.
Plus deck tech with so I'm actually open to playing Black Ivory Animator versus Miracles, or if you guys want us to play any of the decks that we listed in our title, we're currently have Agrolom, Miracles, Death and Taxes, and Black Red Randomator sleeved up. So, Ancestral 93, you're saying you want to switch it up. If you want to make a request, I'm going to give you a few minutes to do so. So make a holler if you want to see something different than Black Red versus Miracles. I'm not catering to the audience if you're going to watch.
Oh, yeah.
So, man.
So, Miracles.
Miracle.
So I played quite a few decks in the past that have involved Griselbrand. Corey and I were joking the other day because we kind of, you know, had made the claim that show and tell was my style of play. But the more I think about it, I think I'm just more dedicated to Griselbrand, a disciple of Griselbrand, if you will.
Yeah, because you have played like Tin Fins and Reanimator in the past.
Yeah.
Never Black Red Reanimator. This is the first time.
This is the first time.
Yeah, this is in your hands.
But I mean, like, who doesn't like drawing seven cards and then getting seven life back when you attack? I mean, it's a good feeling.
So, do you want to reset the wins and losses?
Oh, yeah.
And then, I mean,
we should do it. So, if you're interested, audience, the decks we're playing are pretty much the lists from the GP Louisville.
This one?
And, the Miracles, yeah, is Brian Bronwyn's list. This is the list the guy who top 8ed for Black Red Reanimator. And then the Death and Taxes deck is Craig Wesko's list. So, pretty current lists, pretty up to date with the meta. I don't know about Corey, that's his own. Agrolom's his baby, so.
It's not my baby. There's definitely better players than I who have sculpted the deck. Obviously, my sideboard choices are my, or like, but I'm not saying any of it is original by any means. Like,
yeah.
These are all cards that I've been playing in other sideboards. I just like certain cards for my playstyle. I started playing Legacy with Maverick, actually.
Yep.
And when Miracle started to dominate and take over as the deck to beat, which it's been for like, what, 3 years, 4 years? 3 years, probably.
Yeah.
That pushed Maverick out of the meta, for the most part. Like, it just...
We tied. 7-10. Loaded dice.
I was still going to tournaments with Maverick, and I was actually winning. Never took down a tournament. Only got, like, second place and won, but, like, top 8 is pretty frequently.
Yeah. All right,
I see.
I got it.
And then, God, 2 years ago maybe, or a year and a half ago?
Yeah.
It was at a European GP that two of it topped 8. Then a guy got it in SCG Philly, took it down with the list. I've been hopping around between that, Agrolom, and lands. I can also play lands, but... where we're at in LA, well, we're in Orange County, but LA, where most of the Legacy tournaments are at, it's very heavy Death and Taxes. So with the new printings, it just has totally kicked lands in the crotch. When you're like going to a tournament and like a fifth of the room is Death and Taxes, like It's just, it's, yeah, it's pretty rough. Plus, like, Show and Tell is really heavy internet.
Okay, man.
Miracles is not so much. I'm looking.
Yeah. That's actually one thing we always kind of talk about is how I usually board heavily for Miracles when really we have one Miracles player in our LA meta who's consistently on the deck. You get a rogue player here and there, but really, as popular as it is everywhere else, LA kind
of... Of the top players that play in Los Angeles, there's
sure.
probably, like, a handful of them that play. Like, VD will come out and play Miracles every once in a while, but he's...
Oh, really?
Yeah,
I've
yeah,
only
yeah.
ever seen him on Chartless when he's not playing something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially even at, like, our local meta. Well, actually, I lied. Spellground or Spellhold?
Yeah, Spellhold, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. There's a lot of Miracles players there.
All right, there
but
okay.
that's just a weekly for, like, the prizing tournaments where we're fortunate enough to, like, an hour drive from us every month or every other month. There's two shops that hold Legacy Staple tournaments. So, like, they'll have dual lands up for, like, bid and, you know, Force of Wills, Wastelands, just, like, staple cards. Like, you'll see LED sometimes. Mox Diamonds or whatever, but, not a lot of, Miracles players in that meta. A lot of Death and Taxes.
Sorry, if we're not doing a great job showing your hands, try to show them a little bit better, guys.
I want to show Chris.
I'll cheat and look. I don't care.
Yeah. I have him out, right?
Yeah.
Is it cheating?
Dude, when I was a kid playing Yu-Gi-Oh!, the tournament organizer who would play in the event at the local event would play, but sit people with their back to a mirror and cheat the whole time and win every week. So, I'm not a big fan of the cheatings.
What store is that?
It was the Shoe Repair off of Portova.
That's funny.
Yeah. It's Eve.
Oh, yeah.
Take. I want to have top. Take top.
Alright.
I don't know if that's right, but take it.
Oh, Joe. Good.
This.
Sure.
Let's start Rissa Daddy and my super sweet Badlands.
Yeah.
I don't have to sleep up currently.
Yeah. What was the thought season?
Well, I had two fetches. He's on a beer run.
I'm on a beer run.
Yeah, linger. Chromox?
Sure.
I'm printing.
Yep.
Try to cast animate dead. Targeting Crystal.
No, no, no. It doesn't target yet. Okay. It goes in the battlefield first, and then it targets. But
it does remove.
No. Brainstorm.
Sure.
Yeah.
Did I kick it? No, a little off. I don't know.
That's fine. Yeah, animated results.
Stress.
Okay.
Thanks, Firestone. This magic broadcast brought to you by... You dare pour beer over Legacy Disables. I like to walk along the razor's edge. Take it to the limit.
So the funny thing is, though, is that you should pour it to give it a little foam, right? A little foam.
Yeah, a little foam right there.
Yeah,
a little
I mean, like.
A little more head?
Yeah.
This is where the flavor's at, they say.
Well, just to open up the beer. I mean, you don't want too much foam. Water.
I'm gonna make this thing ad free. This is silly. $2, you can
have it. Go ahead. I'm dead this game.
I'm pretty dead this game. 6 year?
Yeah. I'm not even up to this.
Girl 7?
Yeah. Yep.
I'm going to clean it. Go ahead.
Yes, I'm cutting
it. Sure. I probably should have played that differently. I got a little too cocky. Hold this.
Customers?
Sure.
Targeting Ponder?
Sure.
Cast Ponder. Go ahead.
Combat.
Yeah.
Fix it.
Yep.
That's a zoom.
And of course, pitch camera. Yeah.
Right into it.
Jesus Christ, some cards.
A bunch! All of the cards.
Oh. He's got the heart of the cards.
Yeah, they actually put out an iPhone game for that recently. Like, Yu-Gi-Oh! You can, like, play for free now on your phone. But this morning, it's kind of a stupid game.
I mean, well, it's a Hearthstone really changing the game of,
I mean, there's so many ways to go about this. I guess I just am overwhelmed with my options. First things first. Thoughtsies.
Targeting. Can't have any of my lanes, bro.
Oops.
Nah.
Sure.
Yep.
Come on, where's three? Awesome.
What are you tapping for the intimate? One of the.
One of these.
Yeah. Okay. Two? Yeah.
Three, six, eight. I got a. You know?
Yeah. Yep.
So your turn?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Bounce your white. Petal, bounce your tundra. Chromox, printing, bounce your fetch land.
No fetch. Yeah.
That's your white source?
Yeah, I'm still.
We did it, Ingvong.
Jeez.
Okay. That'll make you maybe hate or love playing Miracles less, maybe? Maybe? Actually, this should just be wins, right? Would make sense.
Miracles doesn't run rest in peace, huh?
There's a couple on the side. They can. That's remember, that's Brian Bronwyn's list, so he chose not to if it's not in there.
I mean,
Three. Oh, I see.
I kicked it again.
That's fine, I think.
I don't know how fair this is.
Okay.
Three surgical extractions? That's his list. That's his list.
It's his list. So, like, I mean, it's meant to beat this deck. So, like, you know, if you beat this deck, that's what happens. Yeah, I don't need either, so we're just gonna do the light side boarding for this one.
Well, I don't think you need to board him much. I think I'll take this design to beat this deck.
Yeah.
Jeez. Okay.
Thanks for watching, everybody. We really appreciate you guys tuning in on a Friday night. We know you can be anywhere in the world right now. Just agree with us.
All right. Enough of that. Fuck, man.
So the old radio personality's coming out. It's a beautiful 40 degrees here at that point. I don't know why I'm shuffling right now. My brain can't function without my head moving. That's just fine. 553. Yeah, not sure if that's right, but we're gonna give it a whirl.
Okay, we should have 60 cards. That deck is designed to be really good against Death and Taxes too, right?
I think it pretty much stomps over because of the zero counter ability.
Yeah, the chance there.
I mean, if you beat him before turn two, it seems fine. Or you board and collect brutality and kill their Thalia, you know?
Yeah.
You gonna be able to play?
Just so they can. In my hand. I don't know how focused that is.
Here. Switch over so you can see.
No, yeah, right. I don't want you to see my hand. Get out of here. Cheater. Alright. I'm on the play. Alright. Go ahead.
Ooh, your turn late card. I'm gonna move to my next step.
Okay. Start your instant.
Sure.
Surgical extraction. Elishnorn. Okay, I see.
Yeah, you got three mentors main board. Or zero, if you know.
Iona, gross. Gross man.
White. I'll name White. Good night. So I went for the full hand discard, but I'm getting surgical as punishment. But it's okay. We boarded out one of the Gristle Brains assuming this was going to happen. That's why there's only one in there.
I'm actually looking at what he boarded in against me, too. It's a real another advantage that surgical extraction has. Kind of have no one else. But, like, for example, I thumbed through his deck, I saw only one other Abrupt Decay, and then know that that's in his hand, so I know that he only has two Abrupt Decays. Saw that he boarded in the Iona, which, you know, light on that, so just knowing that information is pretty nice. And then, obviously got two creatures he can deal with, but he's got no discard outlet other than that, but that doesn't really count.
Black,
you get rid of the Abrupt Decay. But then he's like,
no reanimation.
Yeah, but no reanimation thing. And then, yeah. So then, my turn. Draw.
I'm not totally stressed though. We can go slower against this deck. We don't have to gas it so hard.
Good. At the end of your draw phase, I want to fetch.
Sure.
I'm going to cast Vendilion Click. I'm going to cast Vendilion Click, targeting you if it resolves.
It resolves.
You can keep that.
Okay. We're going to go for that discard again.
Since he's divided.
Sure.
I'll sweep for three. Pass that.
Wait a minute.
Go to your end step. At your end step.
Wait, even let me do that, bro?
Oh, sorry.
That was good.
Plunder. Jones. Rinse.
Cast
a mask. Do you lose a life or no? You just have to discard her.
Yeah.
It is yeah.
Yeah, you may remove a black card from your hand from the game instead of paying them. That's
okay. So it's not like.
Not exactly, same thing. Because
okay.
This was alliances. This is visions. That doesn't feel good either way. I guess we'll take the force. Side one. Boy, that's not good. Well, I wish that a mask was a cabal therapy. It felt a lot better.
Where'd that elf shrine go?
Getting there.
Oh,
boy.
Yeah, no one's lost. Yeah.
I can camera now. I'm guilty.
Baby. So three.
I'm pretty sure I can't win, so let's just see what lands we want.
Snap cast range.
Results targeting?
Targeting surgical extraction. Cast surgical extraction emotional. Should be at 16.
Look from either
Elish one?
Yeah, your other Elish one. Mm-hmm. It says
Rothline.
Weird. Still there, looks like. But all these stats went away.
This and I kept two terminuses hovering.
Yikes, you got me. Alright, hold on. Stats are back again. It looks like there's just a glitch on their end.
See, this deck is way too broken, man.
I mean,
this deck
no,
should not
argument.
Be legal.
What would you what would you do to fix it, man? That old age-old debate. Talk to them for a second, too.
Ban Terminus. I think Terminus is way too strong of a card.
You don't think it's the top?
No. Okay, so...
I mean, like, I don't...
I hear the issue with that there's other decks that run top besides just Counterbalance, and they kind of require top to, like, be consistent and stuff. I mean, they were going to be pushed out of the meta anyways, right? Like, yeah,
like Nick Fit?
Yeah, Nick Fit and, like, Dead Guy Ale, right? Dead
right.
Guy Ale is like, the other one that people talk to, but, like, no, I play Dead Guy Ale. Like, I need to have top in my deck. Yeah, I hear that, but, like... Your deck's not really...
Hey, your deck sucks anyways.
Yeah, I mean, it's like walking into a... And I've seen this before, so that's why I use the example. Walking into a legacy game with, like, playing Madness, right? Like, the blue
Madness.
Yeah. It's like, you know, these are relics of the past that were, like, somewhat... Oh, I don't know about Madness. Madness
was awesome
yeah.
back in the day. I mean, extended.
But that was... Oh, it was extended? That was good?
Yeah.
Okay.
And standard. I mean,
standard.
It just carried over.
Yeah, I don't know. I can maybe get into Frontier.
Yeah.
Because, like, my beef with Modern is that it just, it's too much hand-holding magic, right?
Right.
Like, it just doesn't allow you to play the most broken shit because, like, they're, like, feel-bad moment games, right? Like, why isn't Stoneforge Mystic unbanned and Jace unbanned? Like, when Modern first came out as a format, they were saying they didn't want it to be Legacy Light. But, like, even Stoneforge Mystic and, like, Jace the Mind Sculptor aren't played that often in Legacy anyways, right? It's not, like, a format-defining card, you know? And, like, the fact that they have to ban cards like Splinter Twin and Birthing Pod, it just tells me that, like, you're just, like, you want to feel good. Like, you want to coddle players into, like, loving your match, like, loving your game. As opposed to just, like, letting it speak for itself. I don't know. I think that... Yeah, and you know what? Modern is not for everyone. There's a reason why Modern is, like, the most popular format, right?
Is
like,
it the most popular format?
I think it is. Like,
yeah.
Standard right now is just, like, totally poo-poo.
Yeah.
But, like, I mean, and they say Standard is the most popular format. But people, like, who, like, really invest in the game that stick around longer than, like, 2 years, 3 years.
Yeah.
Are more apparently in Modern than, and I get it, right? Because I mean, I think we all fell victim to that trap, right? The
sure.
couple rotations and then your card values like go to shit, and you're just like, what the fuck?
Yeah, hate this.
I mean, that's you and I jumped on Modern before we got into Legacy.
Yeah.
Like,
I mean,
I don't want to spend that much money, maybe a little money. Well,
well
and then back then too, it was like so much cheaper than it is now.
Well, but I also had some modern decks pretty viable from back when I was playing. Because I played standard during Mirrodin, you know, dark times. So yeah. I had Affinity to come back with. I think that's how we kind of got into it, I think.
Yeah. But, I don't know. And I did have a modern bug. I do get a modern bug every once in a while, right? Like, I played, like, when it was, like, PPTQ season and Liliana of the Veils were the prize. Like, I grinded, won, went to a tournament, like, and just, I was always on Abzan, because that's, again, that's my favorite. When I'm playing Magic, that's, like, the color combination I want to play. Green, white, green, black, put those together and you got Abzan. Not like, black, white, because that's, like, Orzhov is, like, a totally different feel to Magic than like how I play, but mostly like just big green guy and removal spells are like, I don't know, not just like, I don't know. I think Orzhov is a pretty weak color combination in scheme of things. Like Boros is that way too.
So is yeah, I was gonna say Boros exactly. I was gonna say Boros. And even to an extent,
like there's a reason why Mardu is like the three color combination that just never wins, right?
I was gonna say, to some extent, black red.
Yeah, because like the best aggregate decks are red decks, right? But red green.
Red decks, yeah.
Yeah, red green. And red white is sometimes viable in some standard formats and stuff. But
it was during Gatecrash.
Yeah. But you're mostly red green splash white, right?
Right.
Naya is like the best.
I think that's the deal.
Yeah. And then it's funny because in this format, you can't even play cards like that.
Wild the what?
Wild Nicodles? Sure.
I'll kill you with Crystal Brain. That was one of my favorite pieces of coverage from the little bit that we got from Louisville. Was the Cedric Phillips plays, or his opponent plays Goblin Guy in turn one. He played Crystal Brain. He figured out how to.
Yeah, that's cool. Oh man. That sucked on having coverage for Louisville. And like they say like they're never going to do that again, but you honestly think they're going to have coverage for Legacy?
I don't know. I tweeted as much as I could. I spent the whole Sunday watching from Twitter.
Yeah, watching Twitter, yeah.
Yeah, being mad the whole time. You know?
Susie the Gnat, right? That
was her name. Susie Text, yeah, that thing. That was awesome.
Yeah.
Alright, guys, sorry to delay. We're back. I've been cooking all day. I've been making carnitas, so I had to pull my.
I don't care about your cooking, man.
Whatever.
I care about your magic.
Alright. Carnitas magic.
Carnitas magic.
Did we update the record? Hold on. Did I do it? Alright, okay, cool, sweet. Do this.
Alright, so you're on the play?
Yeah.
Alright. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again. This is why I hate playing decks like your deck. Any other deck, I'd keep this hand.
I don't know. This is
against you, I don't think I can keep this hand. Well, okay, hold on. So you board out your like your speed for grind, right? Like to
a little bit.
All right, I'll keep this. Fuck it. Fuck it. Fuck
Thug
it.
Life.
Fuck life. I keep.
Yeah. Is it me?
Yeah, you're gonna play. I'm talking to keep this hand. Pass. Right. I can't force you to play Magic.
You don't have to, bro. I cannot play Land of the Past if I want. Whatever. It's probably not the best when you're on the play, but I mean, it's probably better than when you're.
Oh.
Yeah. Show your hands to the king. Go to Mansa. Is it worth it? Let me work it. Put a face down, flip it, and reverse it.
Great.
Force of will. That joke would be less funny prior to this game. What is a milk stout?
What's a milk stout?
Yeah.
Oh, it's just more of a creamy stout. I don't know.
Is it actually have milk in it?
I don't know if it actually has milk in it. It might. Well, I say that because you're like deathly allergic to it.
Why you gotta ruin everything with milk? You put in beer, get out of here. Drunk, I guess.
Yeah, I have no idea if it's actually in the... I mean, they use coffee beans for coffee stout.
For sure.
But it's like more like put in there as it's like ruined. I'm gonna play since it's a long time.
Woody-hoo!
And then,
That's what I feel. Go ahead. Sure.
Okay.
I said fetch.
Yep.
Did you fetch once, twice?
I fetch once, yeah.
While I'm in here, I'm going to try him too.
You got it.
Ooh, that's me too. Ooh, gang, kick the camera. Ah, sorry guys, I didn't mean to kick you. You good? You good? You good.
Yeah, you're.
Tri-cast. You do.
Surgical extraction targeting Iona.
Sure.
Syrian?
I got a Zoom, let's say Meyer. Myers.
You're just not playing lands? Well, I guess you like passed and then passed again, so you're down two land draw?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. I'm looking up another image, looking through the deck.
Get that for you, that you already know. And I have three abrupt decays, by the way. Your comments in the last.
You have three abrupt decays?
Yeah.
Why did I?
You only saw two. I don't know why you missed that, but there's three. Maybe it's because they are all looks alike.
Yeah, there's three.
Oh, that's three of them.
There's three abrupt
decays. Okay, talk bad against your kind of battle, man.
Right. Yeah, I don't think so.
Exhume?
Yeah.
Yes. Go ahead. Boo! This guy's a phony.
You know what you are?
You're a phony.
You're a phony. Go ahead.
Big fat phony.
You know who lives in this house?
Bony.
Big Bad Bony.
disappointing.
I'm gonna talk.
Sure. Any creatures in here?
Draw.
Oh, wait. Respond to that.
Okay.
Fetch.
Sure.
Yep. I guess the argument against the banning of Terminus is that they'll just play Supreme Verdict. But I still think that's better than... Sure. Your second batch?
Oh, no, that's okay. Since it's 25?
Sure.
Trigger.
Boo. And so it begins.
Go ahead. Sure.
Dang it, he knows how to play it correctly.
Sure.
Shucks. Sure.
Trigger. Make it good. Yeah.
I have my chops, actually. Do you like tokens? Yeah. Oh, he's got the two?
Sure,
I probably can see now.
Draw. Triggers. Triggers.
Elish Norn.
Triggers. Draw.
Six triggers, so
yeah.
Seven and nine, right? Or seven, yeah.
Yeah. No. Eight and...
Eight and nine.
No, eight and seven, so 15? Go ahead.
Mercury, so good. Beats you every time.
This deck is just way too efficient, like, right? Like, it's just like such a well-oiled machine that you can just, like, find any answer that you need.
Yeah, let me go get some both dust.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, it is pretty... It's disgusting. Are you going to take some of the fun out of the deck?
Totally.
Mm-hmm. All right, so you're going to keep doing this. You officially won the match.
I have officially won the match. Do you want to go back to game one?
We don't have to go back to game one, necessarily. Mm-hmm.
If you want to jump on another deck,
I've been playing this one quite a bit. If anybody out there watching, we got a handful of you out there. If you want to make a request out of the decks in the title, We got Death and Taxes, Agrolome, Black Red, Reanimator, and then, of course, the Boogeyman Miracles. If you have any requests, holler now. I think, I mean, if you want to keep playing Miracles, I'd be interested in trying Agrolome if you don't care.
Yeah, go ahead.
That'd be an interesting matchup for the viewers, unless we get a different request.
Sure. Have fun, man.
Yeah, I've never
played
that pond.
I don't. Do you? Do you ever? Have you ever like drafted? You don't play cube, huh?
I tried that once with you guys. I would
cube
be interested
so
in it, but I just.
No. The mentors are on the main board.
I got crushed. I got crushed so hard. I was discouraged.
I may have gone down. How many cards I have? Six, seven.
I can tell you what's main if you're confused. If the engineer is close
to the knowing click is
the
sideboard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The EEs are main.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah,
so
these are side.
So I have one more. Oh, there's another Fluster Swarm. God, that card is so good.
Pretty good. Yeah.
I would say it's like a fair mana drain, but like not. Mana drain, if that makes sense.
Which one? The
Fluster Swarm. It's like broken like mana drain is, but like not so broken.
It's comparatively it's wildly underplayed.
Yeah.
I mean Storm's not really big right now.
Other than this deck, would you imagine mana drain being played in any other deck?
I don't know. Oh, here we go. Finally, I get to watch a good format. That's so groundbreaking. That's cool.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, man, we love this format too. This is all we play.
Yeah, we'll play Commander.
Yeah. I feel like everybody plays that. That's, great.
Well, Commander is cool because you can, like, actually get your Johnny out. You know?
Right.
Like, there's no stock list. It's just about having fun. Well, the commander that we play. We don't play 1v1 commander. We play, like, 4-man free-for-all, beers at the table, you know?
Yeah. As it should be. As is custom.
Yes, it is custom. So, yeah.
If you want to... No, you want to keep playing Miracles, right?
Well, unless they want to watch a different matchup.
Yeah, I haven't heard anything.
We just played, Black Red Reanimator against Agrolome.
And then Miracles.
And then Miracles against Black Red Reanimator. So, my main deck is the Black, or is the Agrolome deck, but I jump on Miracles. He's going to play the Agrolome deck, so it'll be fun to see like us piloting each other's decks.
Alright. Man, it looks like a relatively readable thing.
Woo!
The Mirror Guru. I'm pretty sure I know how to play this deck, but it's not going to be working from muscle memory, that's for sure.
Yeah. It's different. It's just like a different angle deck. So,
You guys playing a lot of events? Hey, man, yeah, we're from Orange County, California. We play a lot in the L.A. scene.
Yeah, there's a... So there's two major tournaments in LA a month. The OG one is Nightwear, and they've been doing Staples tournaments for longer than I've been playing Legacy. I've been playing Legacy since Dragon's Gate. That's when I got into
Dragon's
Legacy.
Gate?
No, Dragon's Maze. Dragon's Maze.
Yeah.
That's when I got into Legacy. But yeah, so Lori has been around forever doing like dual land. Prizing. And even though the prices have gone up on the dual lands, she still continues to this day. And then there's Fire and Dice, which is the more, I don't want to say it's the more professionally ran, but like
it's got a lot more space to breathe.
It has more space.
That.
Yeah. They have the camera there, so that's kinda cool if you're on a feature match.
Yeah.
You can go back the next day and like watch it.
Actually on that note, if you watch any of Twitch live streamed events for Legacy, you've probably seen Corey. He's actually on camera quite a bit when he goes up there.
Just at the Fire and Dice one?
Yeah. You end up there almost every time.
Like once a tournament, I'll be on there. Yeah. But normally I'm on Lands. Lands is like my go-to deck, but I just, our meta in LA is saturated with Death and Taxes, and it always has been. And with the new printings with like Containment Priest and Sanctum Prelate, or not Containment Priest, Sanctum Prelate and Recruiter of the Guard, I feel like...
The matchup has gone from favorable to unfavorable.
Yeah, like it was like 70-30, 60-40 in Land's favorite, and then it just went from that to Death and Taxes just like destroying it. So, especially them, you know, like the pros and stuff are only playing one of both those cards, or two of
the
Recruiter.
The Wesco list is two Recruiter,
one Prelate.
That's the opposite end of what
they
were aiming for.
So in our metas, it's a lot of three Recruiter, two Prelate, so,
Yeah, that's cool, man. So, for you guys not reading chat, Brandon said he's plays in a lot of SCG events out there. You know, man, we're jealous because we're on the West Coast. As you know, SCG doesn't really support us in any way. Like,
I used to go, like, the last couple times, get top 16, top 8, when it was, like, day events. Obviously, when they went to the two-day format, they, like, cut the legacy in half and then stopped coming to the West Coast. So, that sucked.
Yeah.
But are you gonna come out to Vegas for the three-event giant extravaganza in May?
Because we always like new Legacy homies. We're going to try and go.
Well, we're definitely going to be playing Legacy there, for sure.
I don't know what you keep for this deck. I guess this is like... I'm on the play, right?
Yeah, you're on the play.
I guess.
I'm going to mulligan this.
I don't know if I'm mulligan this. This seems kind of bad, but the six... I keep it. I don't know. I don't know better. I don't know what to do. We'll learn.
Yeah.
I am 16. I have no way to get out that way. That's cool, man.
That's cool.
Hey, I respect that you're playing Legacy at 16, though. Like,
yeah.
Instead of all the other scrubs playing fucking Standard.
No, I mean, if you have the means. It's hard to have the means when you're 16. Right?
I guess that's true. Yeah.
Like, when I was 16, I was working at Target, making, like, a couple $100 a week.
I guess that's true.
Yeah. Like, I didn't even know really about Magic then. So... I probably would have tried. I mean, Magic was like a lot cheaper then, too.
Yeah.
It's not like it used to be. Well, not like it is now, I mean.
I guess that's the same that I think you could apply to like all of every year of Magic. Well, it's not like it used to be.
Yeah, it's not like it used to be. Yeah, I don't know. Was there a Legacy format when I was 16?
No.
Was it 14 years ago?
If anything, it was referred to as Type 1.5. Like vintage 1.5. Type 1, Type 1.5.
Ugh. Yeah, okay.
I don't know. Is that a play?
Yeah,
that's a card, right?
Synthesis one. Go ahead.
Oh, hey, the sponsorship. That's cool, man. Are you sponsored by SCG or who's your who's putting the steak on your plate?
That's cool.
Yeah.
I wish I was good enough to get a sponsorship. Fuck.
Fuck.
Play any deck I want.
Charles for one?
Yeah, you got it.
This is pretty good. I don't really play Charles very often.
Woo!
Woo! Diamond.
Yeah, results. Oh, wait, hold on.
Oh, wait, no, yeah.
Counterbalance trigger. Oh, get out of here,
Mox
Diamond.
Oh, my God.
Get
wrecked.
Out of here, Mox Diamond.
Wrecked. All right.
Get out of here, Chalice of the Void.
Huh? If that's how you want to be about it, then you can be like that, I guess. And miss that. That was in Wild Telegraph.
Oh, hold on. Engine explosives for zero.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Broke.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
We did it.
Can't really do much about that.
That's right. That's right. like this card. Tyros Tracker.
Hold on.
Okay. What's that?
I might need a Raging Glyph, though.
Do you have a clue card in
here? Yeah, Raging Glyph.
You see my stupidity? I didn't even glue them together. Does this on zero kill this?
Yeah.
Oh, that's why you did that?
That's why I did that.
Okay.
What's up?
So the CMC isn't equal to one because I made it X equal to one? It's just
it's only one. It's
zero.
It's
so
one,
it's
actually
one on
it's
the stack.
It's one on the stack.
Okay. Let's do
wait, is it one on the stack? It might be two on the stack. I think it might be two on the stack, right? Because it's 1-1.
It is two on the stack.
It's two on the stack.
But it's zero.
Yeah. But it's zero on the, yeah, on the battlefield. And zero.
Now
on the
I understand why he made Borges.
Sure.
Oh, here we got more people talking. Black Magic Gaming. That's cool. So I played at a Legacy FNM on Friday. I was on Miracles, and I played four Ponders to try it out. And it was unrealistically good. But yeah, Black Magic Gaming is my sponsor. Thanks, Brendan. Yeah, we launched that, too. That's cool that you're sponsored, man. Honestly, we're twice your age, and we love to be sponsored. Corey's probably better though. He probably could get sponsored if based off of
Force of Will pitching Kettlebells.
Sure. Yeah, okay.
I'll just correct the engineering expenses.
Sure. Did you fetch it all?
I did, yes.
Okie dokie.
Good.
That sucks. I'm gonna waste that your tender.
Yeah. I will talk.
Sure. So, Brandon, since you are sponsored and you have the access to the whole card pool, what do you normally play?
Dark Knight Planescape.
Okay. Right.
Yeah,
Dryad Arbor.
That's it. Okay.
Brainstorm. You can't believe we'll in here and just pay for him with the Mox Diamond? No? Alright. That's fine. It said it deleted the link, homie. I don't know what you tried to send me, but apparently whatever I have modded is deleting links. Sorry, dude. I don't know how to change that right on the spot.
Yeah.
So your deck, how's it feel? Good. It feels good to me. Get him.
Yeah.
We're on that grind.
Go ahead.
16 turn clock, y'all. We're gonna get there. Hey, homie, the link didn't come up. Is it a known archetype we can relate to? Like, are you a, like a Miracles player? Are you a Reanimator player, Strong player? What do you play?
Soundcast Mage, Prince.
That was all targeting Prince, I'm sure.
Yeah. Simp 2.
Grixis Delver. If you search my name on Google, you should be able to find the solution in top 8 in. I don't think I can search Brendan 2000 and have it come up unless it's on Moto. Yeah. So, I'll look though. What's your last name, Moby? Yeah, Pomeroy.
Okay.
So welcome, my god.
No light?
Yeah. Thank god, light!
I'll talk.
Sure. You play Cavernous Souls in the deck?
No.
No.
Like
a one of?
No.
No. Woo! We did it, boys! Boop. Got him. Go.
All sorts.
Okay, dude, well, yeah, man, we'll look you up. I like Grixis Stomper. I have that deck for sure. Can't do anything about that, can I?
One.
So
three.
Are you on the true name Grixis Delver, buddy, or are you on the old school, you know, Vendilion Gurmag kind of thing?
Super 2?
Yep.
I'll fetch.
I know I already said it once, but we got a handful more of new viewers. So I want to say thanks for checking us out, guys. We appreciate it. Having fun playing Legacy on a Saturday.
Jason Lance up there.
Yeah.
I'm going to bring this one.
Okay. Feel free to follow us if you guys want to get more of this in the future. We're planning to do this more regularly, so...
Okay.
Trying to fill that gap that exists, that void of content. Try to put a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit of sense.
Shit.
The camera.
Do you?
Yeah. Yeah, it's like
pretty good. Yeah, you missed it. It's okay. I figured out how to. Just with my foot now. There we go.
Sorry, guys.
Our stand's kind of under the table. We derp sometimes. Forgive us. Oh, is that creature?
Yeah.
Boot chase. Yeah, man. Thanks for watching. How was your pre-release event? We haven't gone to ours yet. Maybe tomorrow. I haven't heard any feedback, though, so I'm totally curious how yours went.
Go ahead. Oh, sorry. Yeah. Don't go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay, so? Yeah, okay, so. I can keep that. Search.
No!
Target sense splasher. Sense.
Good. Top. Great. Huge turnout. 2 Kaladesh and 4 Aethercraft. Nice. Did you crack any of those sexy masterpieces that all kind of slightly look alike but are different, but kind of not, but kind of?
Dude, like, all the masterpieces are sick.
They're really cool, and I really love the ones they picked. They like laundry list of legacy foils. Yeah, fuck.
Cool.
Goes on the bottom. He's putting this on the bottom, y'all.
You can take a look at it too if you want.
I'm sure it's good. Was it Liliana or something? I can't tell. But I'm sure it's good.
Then we'll ponder. Yeah, your turn.
Guess another kind of
oh my god. Alright.
was that on the bottom?
That was on the bottom. We're
gonna talk. That's how we do it, boys. That's how we do it. A little nope. I wish awesome concept is yeah.
No, we're gonna draw off.
In response to this?
Yeah.
Sure. Well, guys, we tried. We survived the Fate Seal top deck, but she still died. All right, best.
Top. Fate Seal.
/skill game. Yeah, it is.
you keep that. I'll hit you for 2. Boop. Yeah, it's your turn.
This is not going so well. Things are starting to look grim. Oh man, that beard is awesome. I really like that beard now.
Super 2. Yep. It's up.
Yep.
I'll go on the bottom.
Guys, I'm just getting wrecked here. Got there. Burning catacombs. Go. Oh no. You guys see my fate coming? Because it feels a lot like I'm about to lose my deck in about 2 turns. Maybe 3. That's what I'm committed.
Super 2. Go ahead.
Come on, top deck. I'm gonna cycle.
Yep.
This.
Yeah.
Waste on your red source?
Sure. I'll talk.
Sure.
We'll chase a little.
Did you pop him?
Yeah, I just popped him. Oh, well, that's drop for turn 2. Who popped it?
Well,
hold on. Hey, you're
okay. Okay. Yeah.
No. Actually, you're fine.
Draw.
Yeah. Draw.
Pass.
Go ahead.
Is it? Agree?
Yeah.
Can I create a new step? No,
I mean,
just
play it. Well, what are you going to find? Give them the library to search for. So you just second land.
I can do whatever I want
you
before I die.
You can do whatever you want before you die. That is your prerogatory.
My first movie, which I wish I'd planned better, it was cool seeing people with 30-50 per-release cards, though. What does that 30-50 mean? First per-release, does that mean you're a new player to the game? EM1 R4K, Emeric? I don't know. Does that mean you're new to Magic because it's your first per-release, or what? What's your story? If so, welcome.
This is my first per-release. I wish I planned better. It was cool seeing people go
30-50 per-release cards, though. I don't know what that means. Sorry, I don't understand your sentence.
Oh, are you saying that, like, people came in and cheated and put cards outside the pool into whatever?
Oh, that's fucking horseshit.
Yeah.
I'd be livid at that. Fourth edition. Okay, so you're not new.
Yeah. So just, like, your shop doesn't police cheating? That sucks.
And you missed pre-releases for, like, 20 years.
Yeah.
Actually, I didn't have pre-releases for 20 years.
I just don't go to pre-releases. I just don't need the cards.
Not anymore,
yeah.
Just play Legacy. If you don't buy the spoilers if you want something, and you don't go to the pre-releases to try to get what you want.
Yeah. I mean, I played Kaladesh, so that was kind of fun. That was like my first pre-release since Theros, I think.
Played Theros a little bit. That was fun.
Yeah. Like, I did new Battle for Zendikar, and did the new...
Are we going to Game 2?
Yeah, we're going to Game 2.
Been shuffling like they're talking.
Let's
go here.
They have a really good sideboard against this deck, my deck.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this coming against...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
An anti-control card.
It's just like super grind card. You want to know what goes in? Yeah, sure.
Yeah,
tell me. I don't
know this.
Okay. So, yeah. Definitely
Boil, Garrick. For sure.
Dreadanite.
Listen up, by the way. It's Corey's master of the...
I'm not a master by any means.
Of these colors and this type of...
Those are the only three that go in.
That's really?
Yeah, yeah. You're designed so well to beat my deck.
Okay.
Or to beat Miracles.
All right.
Don't need scavenging ears.
So this is how you board Agrolome against Miracles, apparently. That makes sense. You probably need all these.
There's an argument for Caracas. There's arguments for the...
Well, there's no legendaries in your deck. Unless you're playing...
Oh, actually,
then it clicks out of the side, so...
You do that.
Yeah.
Yeah. You still want... you still want the Punishing Fires to, like, grind.
Sure.
But you don't need all three.
Alright.
And then you definitely don't need Scavenging Ooze, because, like, the yard don't matter.
Yeah. It might as well be Rest of Peace.
And then Maze of Ith is not very good when there's a bunch of tokens. So. Me, on the other hand, I think that's what I'm going to board in. Again, this is Chris's list. Or, I guess it's Brian Bronduin's list. But I don't own these cards. This is like the second time I've ever played Miracles ever. And to be honest, I'm starting to fall in love. I don't want to say that too loudly because I think this is a horrible deck. Just because I'm a hater of blue. I hate blue. I think Drago Magic is not really Magic, but that's my own personal opinion. I don't know what to cut. Probably Forcibles. That doesn't seem very good against your deck. I want every other card, but the Forcibles maybe is what I cut.
Against this deck, you probably...
And like shave some counterbalances, right? Because those are just going to get replicated.
Yeah, counterbalance you can cut almost entirely. I mean, you keep one if you want, but like...
How many do you run? Four?
Yeah, yes. There's only... Yeah, you only run four in that list. I just play four predict. It's insane. Okay, so, Brandon, with your four predict... Okay, this list that Brian plays, the one we have sleeved up currently, does not play any predicts. Prior to GP Louisville, I was playing one predict in the main, and to be honest with you, after don't know, maybe 10 games. I didn't cast it once. And I had it a couple times, which was nice. But it was, like, always felt like, oh, this play is too cute to really be worth it. Like, this isn't the value play. This play is adorable. And that's about it. So, like, why is 4 better than 1 when I couldn't make 1 work? I'm totally interested. And we love all of you who are watching. Thanks for tuning in, guys. So this is how it works?
Yeah. Fucking Boyle.
Fucking Boyle.
Fucking Boyle. I love that card so
much.
You've
been
a
victim of those walls. Maybe I'll get to turn the tables this time.
Never been a victim of Boyle or Choke because I never play blue.
Mm.
And I love both those cards. It's quite sweet. But Boyle just being instant speech just makes it so good. Alright, I respond to your Snapcast for me. Boyle.
Oh, get him.
Yeah, like, alright, sweet. You get that source of power share or that whatever, but you can't.
I'm enjoying playing and streaming. I'm not sure how long you're going to go for, but.
Well, I want to see that soon, actually.
All right.
But
that's cool. I think people will wait for a cigarette, hopefully.
Yeah.
All lovely legacy players. Boy, I guess I keep.
I keep.
Did I lose?
Yeah, you lost. I come from the land of the That's what we need. We need some music in this shit.
We could do music. I don't know if people would want that on a legacy stream. I mean, I'm down.
Well, I guess they probably want to hear us commentate.
Maybe
yeah.
We can probably put some low.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Caleb Durward?
His music?
Yeah, well, he does like a jukebox thing where it's like people donate money to listen to different songs and stuff.
Oh, yeah. I mean, like.
We're not doing incentives or anything like that.
Yeah, I mean, if nobody's tipping, but if we want to go for it, but I mean, like, I don't care.
Yeah, we're not.
I just appreciate
it. We have real jobs, you don't need to give us money.
Yeah, I appreciate you guys hanging out. That's just cool.
Yeah.
Dig the kind of. Love us some magic. But I mean, this is like playing Deathblade. Like, I gotta find the right land for the right situation.
Oh, yeah, totally. Sequencing your lands is so important in that deck. That's something that I learned really, very well when I was playing Maverick, because I had that same thing too. If you fetch the wrong land, you get wastelanded. You're just like so dead. Yeah, Bob's good. I'll fetch.
Thanks again for playing. I love to watch nothing better than the comfort of my home. Yeah, we agree, homie. We're playing from the comfort of our homes. Glad you get to watch from the comfort of yours.
Swords push.
Oh, poor Bob. Never even had a chance, man.
Yeah.
Never even had a chance.
It's too good, man. You can't have card management. Draw.
Yeah. That's a good card.
Go ahead. It's okay.
Sorry.
It's not top. It's not. Yeah.
It's a card.
It's a card.
I'll take my chances.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Okay. That's true. Oh, sorry. Caramel sugar. Caramel sugar.
Sorry. He's new.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
We know he has a brainstorm. Screaming card trap in the background. Yeah, man, we don't have a screaming card trap in the background. We could move to one if you'd like, but again.
Yeah.
All right.
It's your turn. All right. Yeah, you don't play. I play one. Yeah. 4, huh? Counterbalance trigger.
Sure. Yeah, the stream, this is literally our second attempt at streaming, so our overlay is pretty basic, you know, bitch stuff. But, I mean, hey, you get the idea. I have not updated our algorithm score. I mean, what, have I won one? Was it, was 1-0?
No, it's 1-0.
Okay.
Yeah, this is game, this is our first game two. Jason Langsdorff, revealed 2 counterbalance.
What?
Alright.
Get wrecked.
My turn?
Yeah. Shouldn't have been greedy, folks. Shouldn't have been greedy. I don't know how to play this deck. I'm just learning. We switched.
Jason.
I can't abrupt decay that. Don't play that.
I'm gonna Jason run.
Yeah. You know, we played 5 games of Black Red Reanimator versus Agrolome. He won 4-1. Not so good for me. I should have had a better matchup, but that's a surprisingly difficult to beat. Leyline of the Void plus Chalice plus all the hates. Scavenging Genius and stuff. Then we played Miracles versus Black Red Reanimator. I think we went 2-1, right?
Yeah.
And then we played this. This is just our third match. Third match, yeah. Honestly, we have no time set. We were just kind of playing Legacy of Hope, but some people wanted to hang out. Corey's going to need a smoke in a second, so we'll probably take a 5-minute break. But, yeah, we'll be playing for another game of two at least. Frankcast, another reliquary.
Another reliquary results.
Yes.
That's...
Forgot about Jace. I play him so much and I can't remember what he does.
Blood.
Ooh, that feels bad. It feels real bad.
Go ahead.
It feels real bad. I think I lost, guys. I think this light's fucking out. Should play Liliana because I'm terrible in this deck. Oh, man.
Right.
Such regret. Sure. I could have played Liliana instead of Knight. Sorry, guys. I know you're watching going, you're an idiot. Because I am. You're right.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Another card I can't play. How about you pass and do your thing? Sorry, guys. I fucked up that game. I totally just punted it. It's lights out, I think.
Snap, cast your mage, targeting Great Sword.
Sure. Arm feels bad, man. It does feel bad, man. I fucked that up super hard. Judge.
Jump turn. Super two.
Blood Moon's harsh on my mellow. Am I done?
There, so 2. Play a mountain.
Yeah, it feels so bad. It hurts so good.
No,
leave that. That's good. That's good.
I ain't going. Well, I don't want things to last longer. So 2. Super 2.
Did the England step or the
Oh, that's funny. Okay. The thing about the spell grounds is they like to travel, unfortunately.
I almost bought out the old school, the like legit OG spell ground for this, but card. This feels bad. Should scoop it up so you guys don't have to watch this.
Jace.
I'll scoop it up. Oh, actually, I'm going to have a card. But I can't cast.
Yeah, the blood moon was pretty cheap. I saw Mox Diamond and a Green Source all in the Jace.
Arguably, for my review and for people watching, I played the Knight of the Rogue Warrior. I could have played Lily on it. Do you think it really would have made a big difference there? Because
because now we're racing to ulties.
Right, but
right.
You were still pretty far ahead on that, weren't you? Or was
No, because I was at 3.
Yeah.
Right, I had to bounce, so put it.
Oh, you bounced
play,
to 2.
But you would have played her, got a 4. Then I go from 3 to 5 to.
But whatever pile I split, had I won that race, wouldn't you have kept Jason to beat me?
Depends, man. Just depends
I
on your, you know.
I mean, you would have never discarded the Blood Moon, though.
No.
So
Blood Moon was still would have slept in.
I mean, hindsight's 20/20, but obviously,
yeah.
That was not the right play. I was stupid to walk right into that Jace bounce. Sorry, guys.
I don't just want to see your
folks.
Yeah, try to talk to you for a hot minute while Corey smokes a cigarette. Thanks for watching there, guys. We really appreciate it. It's actually a lot of fun on a Saturday.
Yeah.
And we've dropped off a little bit. We had more. But yeah. So, I want to just keep talking back in 5. Hang in there, guys. We'll be right back. Corey's just smoking a cigarette. I've been cooking all day, so I'm actually going to throw my carnitas, which I've been cooking. Slow cooking a pork shoulder. So good. Carnitas, so good. My belly. Hang in there, guys. Just a few more minutes. Corey's smoking a cigarette. We'll be back. I agree with you. I mean, I haven't seen the Miracles list that hasn't played From the Ashes or something, but I'm purely copying Brian Bronwyn's from the event, so that's what he did. And he got pretty close, and he's the world champ, so who knows? say you ain't, but if you want any, you're welcome to.
I'm good for now.
Yeah.
I ate. Let's come over here. Gotta get the beer.
Yeah, I was, somebody was commenting about the Miracle sideboard, how it's not usually playing, Blood Moon right now.
Yeah.
Playing From the Ashes or something? Seems, I mean, like, it seems right. I mean, they're still pretty, they're both pretty devastating against aggro mode.
Well, against a lot of decks, really.
Yeah.
So many greedy mana bases in, Legacy.
We got it to 18, by the way. That's the highest I've seen. Pretty good. I don't know if it's at now.
It's at 15, yeah. So in your meta in Pennsylvania, what is like the top deck that everyone's playing? So, in my list of aggro loam, which Chris was playing earlier, I'm trying out a 1-up Tireless Tracker. I played it in lands and loved it a lot. Being a Green Sun Zenith fetchable card advantage engine, I felt it might be pretty good. I took the 4th Blob out for it, but I think I'm going to take out the 2nd Sylvan Library instead. I was just trying to weigh... like, what was better, like, a creature versus the enchantment. Enchantment's obviously good against certain matchups, right? Like, Death and Taxes doesn't have a lot to deal with. The more events in Maryland and PA, honestly, but it's lots of miracles and lands. I had 2 lands and 2 miracles left on. Yeah, Grixis Delver is actually, I would say, probably the best Delver deck against lands. You know, there are some times when you can definitely, like, surgical their life from the loam and then just kind of, like, sitting there. Eh. Or, like, Punishing Fire, too. Like, surgicaling Punishing Fire. But, yeah. Miracles, too. I mean, I there's a lot of people who are saying that Bug Delver is going to be the best Delver deck because of the Fatal Push. But, in all honesty, I think that Lightning Bolt, like... has a lot
better.
Of reach. Yeah, I don't know if it's just better. I mean, we'll just have to wait and see how things pan out. I think Fatal Push has a lot of overhype to it. I think it's an amazing card. Like, something that, you know, it's nice that Black has, like, a one-drop removal spell like that. But, I'm going to buy 4 of them. Like, as soon as they're at my local card shop, you know. But, yeah, I don't know. I don't know if it makes Bug Delver better, necessarily. I think that...
makes it better than Disfigure.
Makes it better than Disfigure, definitely. And, like, yeah, Storm might play it now instead of Disfigure. But, yeah, I'll be interested to see, especially the Reed Dukes list, that Bug Leovold TNN deck. I can see playing some of those, but... just have to see. I mean, I'm excited for that card to hit. Tracker seems fine. It'll also become a quick plot with the library, which is a more consistent card. And additionally, Tracker is bigger mana investment by miles. Yeah, no, definitely. With the aggro loam deck, for sure, you're looking for a grindier matchup anyways. It's just trying to outweigh the Bobs, you know, because Bob gets Terminus, Bob gets Swords, which, like, I don't know if you were in the chat earlier, but Death and Taxes is, like, our biggest, most played deck. A lot of people don't play Miracles in our neck of the woods in L.A. and stuff. It's funny when you talk to people, like, in between rounds, smoking cigarettes and stuff, it just people just kind of talk about Miracles with disgust. But we do have a lot of show and tell, which is funny because, you know, I think show and tell, A plus B equals wins. I don't know. There's definitely a skill level when it comes to piloting miracles well. But yeah, it just kind of like everyone kind of poo-poos on it in our meta. There's definitely a few players who play it, for sure. I mean, I don't think you can go to a Legacy tournament without people playing the best deck in the format, but... yeah, no, it's not really played in our meta. We have a lot of fair decks, a lot of Delver decks, a lot of Jund, Shardless. I'm
playing
Idle.
Elves too, to
yeah.
counter the
We do have a lot of Elves, yeah. We have a lot of Elves too to counter the Death and Taxes. Obviously, that being probably the best deck against Death and Taxes. We used to have a lot of Storm, but then Eldrazi picked up and Chalice from One decks in general picked up. So Storm kind of got pushed out a little bit. There's still obviously the dedicated Storm players out there that just like Storm for life. But that's definitely seen a downtick in our meta.
Can I drink this last beer?
Yeah, dude. There's six other more. Six IPAs, anyways.
That's not for me.
But, hey, you want to play one more, and then you want to get on some D&T?
Sure. Sounds good to me.
Yeah. So, we were talking earlier about putting the tracker in, just as a Green Sun Zenithable, target card manage.
Okay.
And just it's nice to grind.
Is that a little bit better before?
Yeah.
Not bad, folks. Not bad. Here's to you guys.
Yeah.
Happy Saturday, y'all. L'chaim. I've been drinking a while, man. This is fun.
Yeah, you don't have to go anywhere.
That's nice. My home. This was my back and five.
Back and five.
We have fun here. I'm sure I haven't fucked up the camera or anything. That looks good.
Yeah.
My hands look sexy. Yeah, that is a pink Apple Watch. What of it?
I don't know. I thought someone was talking. Talk shit, I think I'll watch.
No, not yet. Give him time.
It's actually rose gold.
It is rose gold, exactly. It was rose gold and free. happy Saturday, buddy. Woo! It's fun. I've never really played these colors too aggressively, so.
No.
It's fun to change it up.
Yeah.
Usually these are opposite.
Green and black just typically aren't your.
They were back in extended. I love playing the rock. Pernicious Deed. Death Cloud, Kokusho.
Those are definitely my decks. Like the Rock Rune mid-range decks.
Yeah,
that's totally my jam.
For sure. I mean, like I say, I play it like it was like my thing, but Chris, how many cards are in my deck? Well, actually, the deck I'm piloting belongs to Corey, so I'm going to have to defer that.
It's 60 main, 15 side. Yeah, it's typical 75. Funny that you asked that, when I was playing Maverick, I was actually playing 61 main board.
The Japanese play mostly 61, to be honest with you. So,
yeah.
I mean,
as like a toolbox deck, I thought that was fine.
Yeah, a lot of people do.
You know, a lot of lists on Moto are playing 61 cards. Yeah. So I wouldn't fault anyone for doing that, especially in a Life Alone deck. You know, you get card selection through that card, obviously. So, yeah, I'm going to keep.
Just graveyard, right?
Yeah,
just
graveyard.
That's a good card.
Yeah, yeah. Mach 7 is pretty sweet.
Charge 4.
Alright, yeah. Okay. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Yeah, bomb's good.
All right, thanks, buddy. The small raptor. Thanks, man. I don't stream a lot, so I love every follower. We're going to try to do this more regularly, so if you like Legacy, glad you're following. We're definitely going to put out some more. Go ahead, buddy.
Good.
Operator.
Pretty good, this game.
Zero?
Take zero.
Oh, man. I like that.
Is that nice?
That's good.
And a drop trip.
Oh, I get more cards? I don't like this. I like Bob. It's a good card.
Oh, Bob is a good card.
What do I have at two? More Bobs I can shut off? What do you play
with
your second chalice?
Green?
What do you play with your second chalice when you have it on one?
Probably put it on one again, right? So I can't disenchant it or...
Oh, okay. That's the new. I can see that.
Nice. Yeah.
Okay.
Take two.
Yeah.
go ahead.
You're right, Brandon. Thank you for saying that. He doesn't know that's what's in my hand, but yeah, that's exactly what happened. That feels real fucking bad. Yep. Does seem to be. He's not wrong. That's a good three drop.
Another knight or tireless tracker. You're talking about green sun's targets,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Has to be green, so.
Oh, really? Is that what this works?
Yeah.
I guess I'm going to buy you. I'm not really worried about them.
Well, yeah, second black source is pretty important for Liliana.
Yeah. Three, I guess.
I'm going to respond.
Got him! You got him, boys! I remember my trigger. Woo! That's Boot to City for six.
Yeah.
Did you pay for both edges?
I have not yet, no.
Whoa, what's happening? What's happening? Stop it! Y'all saw that, right? Am I crazy? All right.
Yeah. He fetched, bro. He fetched.
Alright. That's fair. Play fair magic. This will be your draw.
I'll cast Monster Mentor.
Ah, who gives a shit about that? Alright. Dread of Night feels real bad now.
Top.
Got him.
That's true. It's your turn. Four fours.
Unlimited health.
I'll block the Bob.
Okay.
I
missed my Bob trigger like a boss.
Yep.
Oh, no, I'm the worst. That's alright. Get rid of that fucker. Yeah, you are. We did it, guys. We beat Miracles.
Trying to stall the Terminus. Trying to stall the Terminus. I had it in my hand. That and Brainstorm. I was like, oh yeah.
Jaws for one on turn, you know, one was pretty good.
Yeah.
Jaws
for one is good. You may want to adjust. Throw victory under the Chris Lawson name.
Oh. Woohoo! We did it, boys. Let's update that.
It's 2-1.
It's 2-1?
Yeah, it's 2-1.
I think somebody's paying attention. Yeah, that That was a funny glitch. I have not seen that one before.
I think if you hold it down.
No, it just glitched. It was glitched. They kept smashing the minus, and it would keep going up. Yeah, man, so good. I never played Chalice. It's kind of funny you guys are watching. This is like Roar Reversal night for us. We don't usually play these decks, so.
Well, I'm playing his deck, he's playing my deck.
Yeah. And I'm two going on three beer deep, so. And I don't drink a lot, so. No, that's a thing. I'm blaming my losses on that.
Okay.
Because that's convenient.
I'm gonna keep.
Yeah, okay.
Good.
I'm trying to make her phone in a while. The end.
Yeah.
Zero.
Yep.
We're gonna go for the classic dry armor. There it is. It was good.
Draw?
Yep. You know, buddy, we have the capacity to put any Dover deck together. Currently, Sleeve, these are the only four that we have, you know, to be able to reach and grab right now. If you want to see it next time, that's good feedback. We can put one in Sleeves and broadcast it next time, but yeah, not tonight.
Yeah, I can put Bug Delver together.
I can put anything non-green. He can put anything green.
Yeah. Any bug, junk, well, Abzan, Comparison.
It just removes. What's the concept of the deck, Small Raptor, that removes all your lands? Is that like an archetype we know, or some sort of homebrew? Yeah, Brandon, next time we'll put Delver on the list for next viewing, for sure.
It's gotta be lands, right? A Small Raptor? Like, just they're just looping Wasteland and... Loam with Ghost Quarter possibly, and then the only creatures is like the Merit Lage and possibly Tireless Tracker.
He wouldn't count Merit Lage though if he was talking about lands.
Top.
Sup, cool beans? Welcome, homie. Welcome to the fucking Legacy stream. Saturday night, getting drunk. Yeah.
Drinking beers. Playing Legacy, having fun. Top.
Yeah.
It's your turn. You only have one black source.
Oh, this looks like a scrubland. Did I just play this?
Yeah, you just played that.
Okay, so I'll play this instead.
Okay.
Go get me that. Like, that
scrubland?
Yeah. All right. To be fair, it looks exactly the goddamn same. It is no different. Try to discard.
Yeah, discard this. That's gross. Draw.
Yeah, I didn't have double black. I'm stupid. You're right.
Counterbalance.
Sure.
Go ahead.
Someone.
the counterbalance trigger.
Sure.
Since it's results. Chase.
Mm-hmm.
And Jason. Results.
For those in the audience caring, I have four lands in the graveyard, so our knights are 6/6.
Draw two lands.
That's not good, guys. That is not good. Alright.
And you're trying over.
Boo!
Jason. Fetch.
Is that accurate on fetch? Life lost. Yeah, Blue Beans, we're at home. Kitchen table magic for real. I just pulled out all the old film school equipment, got the mixer and the mic and the camera and the stand and all that stuff, so you guys can chill it out with us.
Monster.
That's a good card. Yeah.
And I'll pass back to you. A trigger kind of.
Not a two. Not a two.
Yeah, resolves.
Go.
And you don't play Council's Judgment in this list, right?
No, he doesn't. Which, prior to switching up to the Brian list, I played two. So, I don't know what's right.
I agree, Brendan. Don't tell him that, though.
Brendan says you're mentoring to a certain level of Deathloop at play.
No, I wanted his Liliana to go down, so it didn't ulti this turn.
Who knows?
That was my thought process behind all that.
I never got to make a Raging Clue token. This is my Raging Clue token.
Yeah.
I think it's funny.
Jace.
Yeah.
Where's
the best place to buy sleeves? Yeah, I was going to say, I buy my sleeves at my local shop to support my local shop business. Honestly, they're going to be the same price, if not more expensive, online. Sleeves are, what, $10? Like, yeah. That's a card.
Go ahead.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Sure.
Blood. Jace. Go ahead. Remember, you can take life.
That's right, I can. I'll take 8. Seems good.
Yeah. Woo.
Oh, actually, I didn't need it because they were all mountains. That was a bad play. who cares? You guys play Death Deck. We're going to get breakfast with a female in the AM. That's cool. You got a female at 16. Good for you, homie. Vraska deck today. I was so pissed. That deck is BS. A Vraska deck in Legacy? Go on.
Oh, Nick Fit. Yeah, blow resolves.
Oh, Nick Fit? That's what played Vraska?
Yeah. No, no, no. It's a mountain.
It's an island?
It's not an island anymore.
Alright. Do we need to go up?
No, we haven't done it.
We're going up.
Well, wait. Were you at 4? Were you at 5?
Mm-hmm.
You're at 5? Jace.
Zelda off Amazon.
Want to serve him?
Sure. You can do his dance all day. You can just get to 6 and you do that.
Sure.
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 Bullshit. You got the double tops going? This is not looking good, folks. About to feel the hammer fall.
Go ahead.
All right, how do I split this? Let's pop Lily. All right. I feel like I'm going to lose if I don't. And I didn't look at the top 3 because I'm an idiot, but I will. Oh, well. Those like that.
That?
I don't know if that's right, but let's do it that way. Yeah, GG's fucking right. Yeah, I miss library. I know. I'm an amateur. If I played this card, I'd remember. On my deck.
Trigger.
Of course, because we know it's there. That's fine.
Fetch.
Yeah, Brennan, I don't know. That might be like one of two times I've ever lit Ultimate with Liliana, so. Damn stream delay. You gotta type faster so I know how to win this game, bro. Fuck.
I'll swing for 5. And then I'll pass back to you.
Not forgetting this time. I don't think it's relevant, though. That's all, folks. Well, that ends that match. I guess we go to D&T now. But what do you guys want to see? We have D&T, Black Red Reanimator, Miracles,
Aggro Loan.
And Aggro Loan. Thanks for watching this far after, man. It was good having you, buddy. Have a good night. Yeah, so if you guys want to call what you want to see, play whatever. I'll lose to with whatever. It's weird going through this deck. I'm like, okay, that sideboard. Oh, no, wait, these are main. Yeah, that's right. Gaddock Teague main?
Gaddock Teague's main.
It's main. Red Knight isn't what I'm on.
This is three, yeah.
Black Red versus DNT. All right.
Right. You want to run the DNT?
Yeah, I'll run the DNT after I'm done, right? I'm going to get crushed again. They are all the top 8 lists. Yes, you missed that earlier. We were advertising. Black Red Reanimator, Death and Taxes, and Miracles are all the exact mirrored lists from GP Louisville. So they're the most current. Aggroloom's Corey's list.
Yeah, the Aggroloom's my list. Earlier, I was saying I typically play lands. That's like my normally the deck that I play, but our meta is very heavily DNT, and with the new prints from Conspiracy, Sanctum Prelate, and Recruiter of the Guard, it just destroys lands. I play so much DNT not only in like the big tournaments or like the big local tournaments that we have. But this fool has a DNT, and my twin brother has a DNT list. So it's like, everywhere I go with lands, I used to be very favorable, and then now I just get crushed. So I put Aggroloom together, which I don't know is the right call. I mean, there's a lot of mid-range decks out there, which a lot of them are better than Aggroloom. Like, Shardless Bug is a pretty hard matchup, but it just crushes DNT, and... Legacy is like the eternal format, right? Like
the best format.
The best format. There's only one other eternal format, Vintage, but that's like with all the Moxen and just super broken cards, like Mana Drain's legal in there. Oath of the Druids is legal in there. Like there's just like
Black Lotus is legal in there.
Like, well, yeah. I guess it's not a Moxen,
yeah.
Right? So. Yeah, it's
Magic but expensive. Yeah, that's a good way to put it. An average Legacy deck's $1,500.
$1,500. Like,
yeah.
For, I mean, you could build Burn. Burn is, like, still competitive, which is nice that they have that option. DNT was cheap until they didn't reprint Rishon Import, and that really bumped the price of it up. But it's still relatively cost-efficient for a Tier 1 deck. Miracles is not even that expensive.
Like the Volcanics and the Tundras and the Western Cousins of Bardo.
Yeah, but you play 3-1, 3-2.
You play... Well, it depends on who you are. Too,
yeah,
much,
it depends
but I mean,
on
like,
your
3
list,
2,
yeah.
2-2 would be very playable.
Yeah.
I mean, I think you play 3 Tundras, but...
Bizarre library. Yeah? Yeah, Burn, like, for the decks that I play, Burn is always a scary matchup. It's, like, probably one of the most stressful matchups that I ever play. I liked it a lot better as lands than I do as Aggroloom, because you can chain the... Is this the Black Red Rander?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can chain Glacial Chasm with Thespian Stage, and if you have a Life from the Loam engine going with Exploration, you can still net a mana each turn and sit there and, like, Punishing Fire them down, or... which is like your most go-to move. Sometimes if you have enough life cushion, you can Merit Lage them. But for the most part, you're just like Punishing Fire, Molten Vortex, and them down.
Update our little overlay here now that we're
switching
it up. Corey's coming out the winner tonight, I have a feeling. I'm not a doctor, but simple math tells me.
So, I've yet to play with Black Red Reanimator. I mostly play Blue Red Reanimator.
I think I've seen you.
Or
Blue
Green or
Blue
Black Reanimator.
Blue Black, yeah.
Blue Black. I've top eight a couple times with it. One of the spicy techs that I really love, a guy named Andrew Son in our meta came up with. I mean, I don't know, he can't be the. I can't put all the props in, but one tech that I really love in the Blue Black Reanimator deck. Is main board Pithing Needle. He main boards two of them. Obviously, that's for like Deathrite Shaman, But also has like fringe applications too. Really good for like curse catcher even when like or like Caracas, which is probably what it's in main there for. But you can also get like Aether Vials and stuff too if you're ahead and you're not like wanting them to vial in Flicker Wisp or something like that. So I really like the main war Pithing Needles in a standard. But the Chancel of the Annex is kind of like definitely sped up this deck.
Cool beans. What format has the most restriction? That's a kind of an interesting question.
Modern.
I mean, arguably any of the quote-unquote eternal formats are non-rotating. I mean, I guess go look at the banned and restricted list and see what has the most. But I mean,
modern probably, right?
Really, I think so.
Yeah. Modern has way more banned cards.
I don't play modern all that much, so I don't look at that list. But yeah.
So yeah. Modern was.
Brandon, I'm with you too. I've had a mask since the days of Extended, and yeah, it feels good to see them go up to like $40 a pop or whatever they are now.
Unmask is?
Yeah, Nick was saying they were up to 40. I don't know if he was just full of shit, because I think you can find them on TCG for like 20 now.
Holy shit.
But still, yeah, it was nice having them. I think I picked them up super cheap too back in the day. Feels good.
Really? Unmask?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Well, it looks like I'm not ever going to put this deck together.
You can borrow mine, turns out.
Yeah, turns out Chris Lawson has them.
I have it.
Just to give you a little background. So, Chris and I started playing roughly around the same time. I played.
I've been playing Magic since Onslaught, I'd say.
Yeah, but you really like came back to it.
Came back to Legacy when at Gatecrash.
No. You came back to
Magic.
Yeah.
Gatecrash. And the Legacy.
So, So Chris and I, and I was playing Standard at the time too. He was as well. And that was the Innistrad, Return to Ravnica blocks. And rotations really hurt the wallet, you know? Like,
Standard's more expensive, honestly.
Yeah, like, if you're playing Standard for, like, 3 years, it's more expensive than Legacy. Like, one Legacy deck, for sure. Obviously, you're playing it little chunks at a time, as opposed to, like, you know, one big, large investment. But, him and I, we tried Modern out first, but no one wanted to play it. This was, like, SCG didn't even have it with, on camera at that time.
Losing dice rolls, not good.
Yeah. And, yeah.
Okay.
Alright,
Okay. Go ahead. That's weird. It's a bold move, Cotton. Let's see how it pays out for them. Yeah.
Into.
Sure. Modern is poop. We agree.
Yes, Modern is
poop.
Cool
beans, Modern is poop. Don't even bother looking. It's poop. It's poop, poop, poop.
Yeah, Modern is poop.
You can look it up in the dictionary. There's a steaming pile of poop next to its definition.
It's definitely more friendly to players. Legacy, you get to play the most broken cards in the game, for the most part. That's not, like, vintage. But, yeah, it's poop.
Play Standard local events. That's cool. I honestly, sometimes I want to play Standard, but I never want to put the money into actually having Standard decks, so I never do. But I have recently just joined EDH, and I'm a big fan of Titania. Mono green, land destruction, make a bunch of guys, crater hoof them in the face. That's my jam.
Yeah, he doesn't have an Elves deck in Legacy, you know?
Yeah,
he should play Elves.
I play blue in Legacy, but green in EDH.
Yeah. Alright, reanimate Grizzlebrand.
Standard is a soundtrack to a coma. That's a fucking good way to put it.
draw seven.
Sure. That's a thing, I guess.
Crack. Take this one.
Yeah, Brea. Not only is she hot, she's kind of like Artifact Khaleesi. That's why I look at it. I like Brea. I don't know. We have the pre-con decks. I have mine still unaltered, but Corey made his all super good and shit.
Good.
Okay. Pretty cast Swords of Cloudfair starting with this brand.
Yeah. We'll get some money. Yep.
Go.
Dark Ritual.
Sure.
Thoughts. What the fuck?
What the hell?
What in the hell? Yeah, we'll do Phyrexian Rebuker.
Good choice. Always a good decision.
Animated. Turning Grizzle Ring.
How do you get another Grizzle Ring there?
Faithlessly. Oh,
okay. Yeah.
We'll throw it back your way.
Yes, better.
Yeah.
Go.
We'll smack you for six. And then I'm going to do the one draw seven. Flashback hit this week.
You want my one card, bro? Come at me. Say it again. Thanks all for watching. Love having you here. Appreciate it. Happy Saturday. Cheers.
Prost.
Prost. Chaim. What other good ones are there? Other than cheers. Mazel? Nah, that's what it is.
Animated. Turning Cyrus enemy.
Horsebound.
Okay.
No, I won't. Is this a triggered ability? It goes with that, right?
It's at the end step.
But it's still triggered, right?
Right. Fuck.
I should probably activate this. I guess it doesn't even matter.
Alright, I'll move to end step.
Yeah.
Yeah. Move to end step, trigger. Fail to bind or?
Yeah, I'll fail to bind.
Discard your hand. Go ahead.
Palace Yale would feel real good right about meow. Ziggy, 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 Ziggy. Oi, oi, oi. Dude, I love that show. I grew up on the Man Show. You're my homie, man. I laugh at your jokes.
Sweet.
13?
7 and 5. Alright, so you take 6. No, you take 6. Yeah, I'm good.
move to this guy. Yep.
All right. So beginning event state, beginning event step trigger, end event step. Draw seven.
Draw seven here.
Well, I'm trying to get tricky. Okay.
Yeah. Thanks for watching, Brennan. It's good hanging out with you, homie. Nice meeting you. Come back again sometime. Follow us if you want.
Super lethal.
Enjoy your 16-year-old girlfriend. Yeah. That went as about out as about expected for this matchup. Thinking this is our last match of the night, yeah?
Yeah.
Kind of getting burnt out. We've been playing for 3 hours and 20 minutes almost. Pretty good.
Yeah. One more game.
On board.
Alright.
Otherwise, there's no chance.
No chance.
Is there no chance?
I mean, it's a rough match so far.
Oh, wait. By the way, everyone who doesn't know, these four are...
The fuck is that called?
Reverent Silence.
Reverent Silence. So it's destroy all enchantments for free if you control a
forest. And give me 6 life.
And he'll gain 6 life.
It's 1 green and 3 colorless. They're coming, they're in the mail. TCG just didn't get them to me within the week. Like they said they would. But I mean, I'm definitely.
All these cards seem so good against you.
Could be the last game of the night. Could be the second last game of the night.
Yeah, this is going to be the last matchup.
Thanks for watching there, guys.
I'm 1-0 currently. You'll be on the
play. I'll be on the play.
Oh, dude. You definitely need to have darker sleeves for this deck.
Oh, because of the
turnover
topics.
Cards, you get, you can totally tell.
You totally can, but I mean, I figure you're not going to cheat.
I'll try not to, but now I know. You didn't need to scry all this time, so I'm going to give it a go.
I mean, the percentage chance that it is relevant. Oh, right now.
match right on top. Better cut.
Yeah, I'm going to get mats for those. I just, I'm going to get some red mats like what you got. That red reanimator. The red is so minimal. So minimal. Did you cut, Gary?
I have not.
Space.
You too.
That's not
right. Tommy,
Tommy, yeah.
Yeah. No, you
don't play.
That's right, bitch. Go. Go ahead.
Tommy? That might be devastating. I hope he picks green.
Thali results.
Just keep the cam. Sorry.
My turn. Fetch.
I feel like this room worked out pretty well.
Yeah.
Definitely better than last time.
The thought season.
Oh, I'll just go to Fair of a Com. Give it up.
Yep. I'll hit Sanctum Prelate. Okay.
Badlands. That's a Badlands,
that's
people.
That's a Badlands.
That's a Badlands. We have the Badlands. We just don't have them to sleep. That's a Badlands.
All right, good.
Yeah. Yeah, go ahead.
Zoom.
it's pretty hard to beat, isn't it? Alright. I will choose two.
Okay.
Pass.
Six for seven.
Take six. No, just take four, five.
Okay.
Actually, you know, take it here. That's out of the block.
Yeah.
No, yeah, take care.
Okay. So we take five. Yeah, it's your turn.
Big boys?
Targeting. Yep.
Good.
And two?
Okay.
Exit.
No, that's fine.
Yeah. Swing for nine. Good. Alright guys, we're going to call it a night.
Yeah, good games though.
Yeah.
Had fun, man.
We appreciate you guys hanging out with us. If you're drinking beers at home, definitely cheers to you.
Yeah, let's finish these off then for them.
Finished. But, you know, appreciate hanging out with us tonight. You know, we had a good time playing in front of you guys. Again, you know, we can make a bunch of different kinds of decks, so feel free to message chat or... is there like a message, personal message or something?
Yeah, I think there is, but if not, railbirdgaming.com or tweet me at railbirdgaming.
Was Tyson part of the main word or something?
Me. I know, it's weird. It's one of the mains. Ellis should I own that, and yeah, those are
yeah, so yeah, so just let us know if there's like certain decks you guys want us to see us play, test, in the future. I mean... we're going to try to do this as much as we can. Obviously, we have lives, too, you know. Girlfriend doesn't like it when I don't hang out with her. But thankfully enough, she's a night nurse. So, you know, there's going to be times I'm going to be available to play Magic for you guys.
Yeah, and I'll, even if Cord's out here, I'm going to try to get more people on so we regularly have, you know, legacy content coming out. But, yeah, thanks for everybody who participated in chat. Emmerich, I think that's how you say it. Cheers to you, mate.
Cool beans. Thanks for hanging out.
Welcome to Magic, Cool Beans, by the way. If you're new, welcome, dude. This is the best format. You should watch more of this every chance you get.
Kind of the deep end when it comes to Magic, but definitely the best and the most fun. Yeah, and all the other lurkers, man, you guys.
You're awesome, too. We love you.
Yeah, I hope you guys had fun tonight. We definitely did. And we'll
yeah.
see you next time.
Bye, guys.